Welcome everyone. I wanted to do a quick video about my thoughts of documentation within the blockchain and how it can apply to Cardano. Charles has mentioned before that documentation could range from putting certificates of graduation or completion from certain universities to documentation that the government needs in order for businesses to be compliant. For example, I'm going to start domestically and then move internationally. I do government contracting, and a lot of government contracting is getting paperwork to certify your company in order to either sell a good or sell a service. So, for example, let's take the Department of Transportation within the United States. In order to transport goods or people across local jurisdictions or county lines or state lines, you have to get all these different convoluted numbers. So you have to have your DOT number, and then depending on what jurisdiction you're in, you have to have your local numbers as well. And the problem with these processes is that they're extremely archaic, and it's a very convoluted process. So it's often companies manually writing out all of their credentials, whether that be their private information, their EIN number, which is basically like your social security number for your business, and everything that you, your digital identity, but it's written on paper. So all your pertinent information. And sometimes you even have to submit certain tax information to get certain licenses in order to operate in a safe manner. And the issue with this is that there's a lot of room for deception. For example, documents can be tampered with, documents can be lost, documents can be destroyed, whether that be like through a fire or some sort of natural disaster. And also this whole idea of collusion as well. You know one person within the government and then they help you get out this license. And the idea of multiple identities for a single individual. So say an individual gets barred from producing this service or transporting this good, they can just reapply under another pseudonym, or they could create another LLC and funnel whatever business that they want into another company or another person. And you may not want these people transporting goods or people in any jurisdiction, but the system can be bypassed. So I see a lot in the future that governments are going to be looking at creating smart contracts in order to do identity verification and produce certain documents. So this way they can never be destroyed and identities can be verified in a quick and secure manner. Cardano's looking at something called sealed glass proofs, and this is going to be using certain hardware that's trusted. So, for example, Intel SGX and ARM, and making sure that the identity is verified for the individual that's producing the documentation. Why do I think this is important? Is because one of the things is in smart contracts, or let's take regular documentation, first of all, you have the government and then you have the verifying party that has to verify all the information is correct. So what if that verifying party has some sort of bias towards the individual who's seeking documentation? Then it may be more difficult for that person to actually get that documentation. And this is wrong. People should have equal and fair access to documentation. So how do you create, I think the government will be looking for solutions of how people can submit information and be verifiable, but at the same time, that their information can be verified and at the same time be permanently stored within the blockchain. So government agency A, like the Department of Transportation, can pull up the file of person A and run their credentials before giving them a DOT number or any sort of local license. So let's move international to Ethiopia. Putting a lot of these countries, you're writing information on by hand. It's stored in some kind of local office. It could be manipulated, and individuals, there's a lot of room for collusion, and there's a lot of room for tampering of quote unquote documentation. So say individual A doesn't want person A graduating from certain university, they can just pay a little bribe under the table and have that information altered. But people would ask also, what about if this happens on the blockchain? Can't information be tampered? Well, the only issue with that is the only way information can be tampered with is the actual information that's being inputted into the blockchain before that smart contract gets verified. So for example, say I'm putting in wrong information So there has to be a method to control falsely putting in information into the blockchain. And I think that's where TEEs are going to come into place. And this whole idea of what Charles was saying, I think that Charles really wants to create this kind of PGP atmosphere for blockchain. And what is PGP? PGP was this whole idea that we could run the internet in a password-free way. So they would be able to identify the device and the person using the device in a way that's secure and quick. And this way, your identity is tied to the device that you're using. And something similar could be used in blockchain. So say in the future, we have some kind of app on our phone, on our Samsung Galaxy phone, that's crypto-enabled, that verifies your identity in a secure manner. So it's not like your credentials are being floated around to some central party. Everything is in a secure manner. Then you could apply for certain documentation in a way that would be conducive for you getting a particular license. And it could even go down to the individual level. Say you're applying for a passport, or you're reapplying for a passport number. Instead of writing down all the information and slipping the card under some slot, this information could be all presented in a digital way, and you could just, it could be a one-click application, and it gets sent to the government, and the government sends you the appropriate work. So the possibilities are endless, and I think that this is a great way moving forward. I think privacy is going to be key. I look forward to seeing what kind of privacy solutions that Cardano is going to implement. And I think that this is going to be directly proportional to government institutions creating certain smart contracts that allow them to put this identity verification on the blockchain. So it's fun to see, and I look forward to seeing exactly what they plan to do in the future. So that being said, thank you for watching this video, and please put some comments below, and until the next video, thank you.